And welcome to Traditional Painting the Digital Way. This is where I use digital painting apps to teach traditional painting techniques. In this video, we're going to be starting a brand new series called Best Buddies. In my previous videos, I talked about wanting to put a little girl in the road series that I just did, but I couldn't get the background right for her. So what I decided this time was to get a tree and put a swing in it, and this made a much better background for her. For those who want to follow along traditionally, acrylic paint or oils will probably be the best for this painting. These are all the brushes that I use for my acrylics, and I also use a canvas board and wrapped canvas for my background usually. And then here are the colors that I use, and I use Grumbacher Academy mostly, and sometimes Liquitex colors. The app that I'm going to be using is ArtRage for Android, and we're going to go ahead and start by doing the distant trees. And so I like to use the round brush a lot because it sort of looks like a regular paintbrush here. And I'm going to start by adding some light purple color in the background. And you can use dioxazine purple and add a lot of light color to it. You can add hooker's green and a little bit of white acrylic gesso. We just want kind of a light violet color. And you can probably use your number 8 bristle brush for those of you that are following along traditionally, and just make a tapping motion on your canvas and make you call these strokes scumbling, where you make really rough strokes and you just tap the point of your brush on it and make sure that the bristles splay out a little bit so that you get kind of a really rough sort of distant leaf look. And what I have to do in ArtRage to get that look is to go ahead and use the round brush first and then switch to a blending brush. And usually Harsh Chaos is a pretty good brush because it makes sort of jagged edges and gives it kind of a distant leafy shape. And so that's what I'm doing here, is just adding the paint down and then alternating to the blending brush and trying to get that really distant leafy look. And we don't want any dark colors because we're trying to get a distant look here in the background. And I'm using the gloop brush a little bit just because it gives kind of a really weird, uneven, ununiform look, which in nature, like I've said before, you don't want a uniform look. You want things to look uneven. And then I want to add a little bit more green to the background, but we still want to keep it light because it's the background. And so it's going to be more distant, and colors are less intense in the distance. So if you're following along traditionally, you can take your hooker's green and add some white acrylic gesso to that and just make kind of a light green color. Now don't put it all over your violet color. You want to keep some of the violet color showing through, and that kind of just gives you like distant shadows sort of. And so you just kind of want to make patches of green in the background and just continue to alternate between your main brush, your everlasting oils, or round brush. I guess I was using the round brush for this part, and I was trying to see what the pastels would look like too, but they didn't seem to work as well as I wanted. And I also like to use the dry clumps brush and the small frosting brush in the blending category. And these will help give it kind of a leafy look without too much detail. And here I've added some light green, almost yellow color. And if you're following along traditionally, phthalo yellow green would be this color, or kind of a spring green or a light green yellow. And then you want to go ahead and save this because occasionally ArtRage does crash on you. And it actually did crash on me. And it will kind of auto save, but a lot of times it doesn't. And so you kind of lose your work. So you have to be really careful about that. And then I wanted to kind of just use the Everlasting oil brush to make the tree trunks in the distance. We don't want these real big, but they're still kind of dark because they're closer to you. Close enough that they're dark looking and they're also in the shadows. So just make some tall, thin trunks here, and I wanted to go ahead and see if I can make a little bit of highlight on them with the pencil category here, just to kind of lighten them up just a little bit, like there's a little bit of an edge of the light hitting them. But we don't want too much detail because they're still going to be in the background. And smudge the bottom a little bit. You don't want that hard edge, especially if you're working traditionally, because that hard edge is really hard to cover up if you're using acrylics, because it dries and then you have to make the paint really thick to cover up a hard edge. And then I want to go ahead and add some more leaves to these trees, and they're going to be a little bit closer, so the green is going to be a little more intense. So you would still use Hooker's green if you were following along with your acrylics, but add a little bit of white acrylic gesso, but not quite as much as you were for the background, because we want it to be a little more intense. And then here I'm using the Gloop brush again, just to kind of to get that uneven look for the tree leaves. And then I'm blurring it out with the blending brush and the small frost brush or harsh chaos will work well. You just want something that kind of gives it a grainy look or kind of an uneven look, because we still want it to, we want it to resemble distant leaves, but we're still not wanting big detail because this is still in the background. So I'm just kind of working on that, and you have to alternate between the blending brush and your main brush. And I'm using a little bit of the pastel brush here, just trying to kind of play around and get the uneven textured look of the leaves. And then I like to do all these on different layers, because if you mess up, then you can go back and sort of change some of these things. And then we want to add some distant grass under the trees, and we want to make a kind of in layers. So the first layer will be the light layer, and it'll be the farthest away. And so you want to use kind of a phthalo yellow green color if you're using your acrylics, and just kind of smooth it out. You can throw in touches of white, and you can throw in touches of white acrylic gesso. And you can probably use your number 6 filbert brush if you're following along with your acrylics. Throw in a little bit of orange, some cadmium orange. And then here I'm just kind of working on the trees in the background, adding a little bit more purple and a little bit more green, just to kind of add the more distant look again, and kind of make it a little more intense at the bottom right before it reaches the grass. And that just kind of shows distant tree shadows. And then you want to just go ahead and add a darker green underneath those trees right there. And so you could use Hooker's green with a touch of acrylic gesso. And that's just to make the paint more opaque for those that are following along with their acrylics. And you just kind of want to put that underneath the tree trunks and make it look like there's a shadow underneath these trees. And then we want to go ahead and continue to kind of blend that in a little bit, because we still don't want any harsh edges. We want soft edges, and we want everything in the back to kind of look soft and maybe not in real close focus, because we don't want the attention to be on the background. We want it to be on the figures in the foreground. And then here I'm adding the middle ground grass, and you can use yellow ochre for that. And you can just use your round brush or everlasting oils for that, and then you'll blend it in with your blending brushes. And you just kind of want to smooth it out a little bit. Use some cadmium yellow if you want to, if you're following along traditionally. some yellow ochres, just kind of some lighter colors, but it's getting a little more intense as it comes towards the foreground. So here I'm just kind of blending it out, throwing in some darker pockets of brown, and then blending those in, and that just gives it more of the texture of grass out there, and kind of like the ground's a little bit uneven and there's different kinds of grass and maybe there's leaves on top. We just kind of want indications of all that. And then I'm just kind of right here, I'm blending, putting my layers together, because it makes the program run a lot smoother. When you have more layers, it doesn't run as smooth. So this is the end of part one of my Best Buddy series. And in part two, we're going to go ahead and work more on the big tree and the grass in the front. So hit that subscribe button if you want to see part two. Thanks everybody for watching. Thank you so much for your support. If you have any questions, just leave them in the comments down below. And I will catch you later.